farm, which is sort of in front of us, with teams of sheepdogs. They'll drive them down this gully, down the beach, obviously at low tide, and to that red bullshit that I pointed out to you. So, to make it worse, in those days, they only shore once a year, so the sheep, it wasn't only a really long way to go, but the sheep had a very big, heavy fleece of wool on them. So they got sick of that about 900 years ago. Oh, see that tanuki is flowering, very late. I'm jolly sure the sheep got sick of it too, but so they cut a third of that wool shed off and rebuilt it right opposite where we first saw the golf course, so we'll see it on the way back. And so it absolutely, totally revolutionised the farming operation here. And now you can see why we use these small buses. Big buses wouldn't be much use on this trip. And this is called Porpoise Gully because one of these shepherds was showing off that he had seen porpoises out to sea. Well, we don't really do porpoises in New Zealand, we do dolphins. But anyway, they called it Porpoise Gully after him, so that's fairly useless information. Can you see these tracks on the sides of the hills all over the place? These have been made by sheep following one another over the years. I'm going to start telling you about the gaps. We're not very far away now. It's the biggest mainland colony anywhere in the world that's easy to get to. And there are over 20,000 adult birds here, over four different colonies. So we'll be parking up right alongside the main colony. Now, where shall I start? Yeah, the end of next month, by the end of next month, all the adult birds will have left, except perhaps a few very, very old ones. And I'll tell you about the young ones at the end of this story. So the everybody's due a holiday every year, so the adult birds fly up to around the Bay of Islands, north of Auckland, and I think the fishing's better up there, and it's certainly warmer. Then they come back in August, and because they're potentially paired for life, the couple find each other and set about family life, basically. And they're absolutely identical, and the only way you can ever tell the difference is if the as if you see one with seaweed, carrying seaweed, that will be a male. And so the male goes out, gets lots of seaweed, they build a nest with that, and poop and dirt. And the female will lay one egg, and you'll see why when you see the size of the youngsters. The egg is about the size of a duck egg, and they take it in turns, and sitting on the egg and wrapping their webbed feet around it, so one does that and one goes out fishing, since they live on an entire diet of fish.